Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Ryan Specht. Today we're going to be taking a look at the ROCKWOOD Ultralight 2898KS. One of the most important things when you're thinking about getting a new fifth wheel is how much that vehicle weighs and how much your tow vehicle can actually haul. This guy comes in just under 9,100 pounds of dry weight. The gross vehicle weight on this is listed just under 11.5. So this is possible for some of the half tons out there and a lot of the three-quarter tons on the market. Come on inside and let's check out some of the interior features in the 2898KS. Something I wanted to point out to you is we've got all our slide outs in right now, and this is a completely functional kitchen, even with the slide outs in. You have access to your refrigerator, to your pantry. You can even get upstairs, take a nap if you're on a long road trip, use the bathroom. Something I really like to point out, because on a lot of coaches, when the slides are in, it's not very functional at all. So we're gonna bump these things out and then we'll go over some of the interior features on this unit. So this 2898KS that ROCKWOOD has come out with, it's probably one of the neatest new floor plans that they've got. Real good separation between the living room and the kitchen. Really creates three separate living spaces, as you've got a living room, a kitchen, and a bedroom up above. One thing I really like here, kind of a unique setup. So you've got kind of a bar stool setup on one side and almost like a bench setup on the other. So it's a really nice, comfortable, almost little breakfast nook right here. And you rotate right around. Great counter space on each side of your sink. You do have that nice stainless steel double basin sink as well. Nice bank of drawers here for silverware and whatnot. Little flip down for your sponge as well. Above that, you got tons of overhead cabinetry. And I would like to point out while we're looking at this, everything is actually screwed together, not just stapled together. So it's screwed and glued the way ROCKWOOD does it. Nice storage down below the sink as well. And you've even got a good spot for a little trash can, which is nice. Some storage over on the side. You do have a 110 outlet here. Right here, we've got the controls for the max air fan, which is right above us. Pretty nice. We'll exhaust over 900 cubic feet of air a minute. You've also got the rain sensor on it. So if you're out at the lake fishing and it starts to rain or something, you don't got to worry about it. It'll automatically shut itself off and close. Right over here, you've got a really nice kitchen area for your cooktop. Nice redesign on the Furrion cooktop here. A little bit more residential looking. Has that glass cover for extra counter space when you're not using the cooktop. Built-in knife rack on the back. You've also got a light above as well as an exhaust fan, and this actually will exhaust out of the coach. It's not just a fan that kind of circulates the air. Above that, nice 1.3 cubic feet built-in microwave. It'll fit an 11-inch normal size dinner plate. Down below that, you have got all your Magic Chef cooking area here. Really nice. I love the glass inlay that they're doing on them this season. You've even got a light that's built into it, just like you would have on your standard home oven. Right below that, a good drawer for like your bigger pots and pans and stuff. And then right next to that, you've got your 8 cubic foot gas electric refrigerator. Nice wood panels on the front, so it matches all your cabinetry and stuff. But plenty of room for a nice extended weekend with the family. Plenty of room for your freezer as well. If you look up above there, that's a good size. And while we're in here, I might as well mention this coach comes with a built-in 10,000 gallon water filtration system. Nice thing with that for you is whether you're hooked up at a city connection or you're going out of your tank, you're gonna know all the water is gonna be filtered down to 0.9 microns. Really nice pantry here. Something that's pretty neat too is this light in the pantry has actually got a motion sensor on it. So it'll automatically come on when you open the door and go off when you shut it. Now let's rotate on in. This is the really awesome living room that you've got. The way they've set this up, you've got opposing slide outs layouts here. Both of them have the trifold sofas for extra sleeping. And then right across from your entertainment center, you have got the theater seating. Both of these do have the recliner, little parachute cord here that you can pull, and they're wall huggers. So they'll really lay down flat. Does have the heating and massaging features if you're plugged into power. You got a nice little tray table here too as well. So you can kind of sit here with your beverages right in front of your entertainment center. And again, two fold out couches for extra sleeping back here. Really nice area for your entertainment center. It does come with the TV. I just don't typically leave it in it on the lot, but I really like the way they've got like an accent barnwood wall here. It's almost whitewashed, almost like an Aspen look. Nice big sound bar. Below that, this is your RIV Technologies DVD player, CD player, Bluetooth capable stereo. Functions with indoor and outdoor speakers that actually have separate zones. So one guy can be in here watching the Bronco game or whatever. Someone else could be outside jamming tunes. And down below that, you've got an electric heater fireplace. So again, if you're somewhere with hookups or you're running a generator, this baby will save you a lot of propane. It's rated to heat 400 square feet, which we're not quite there, even though this is a very nice size coach. On each side of your entertainment center too, you do have some good storage, a nice spot to put all your DVD or your DVDs, I should say, video games, what have you. Nice on all your windows too, I like to point out. Not only do you have the pleated day shade or night shades, but you have pleated day shades, so you can still get some of that light in without you know, actually having someone the ability to look into your coach. Even with them both open though, you have a really, really well tinted windows on this unit. Before we check out the upstairs, I want to point out the control panel, which is right here inside your entry door. Controls for the three main slide outs. You do have a wardrobe closet slide out button up here. This is the controls for the ceiling fan, which runs off of the 110 power. You also notice as you look up by that ceiling fan, in the living room, you've got another one of those max air fans that'll exhaust over 900 cubic feet of air a minute. You've got your 15,000 BTU air conditioner that is ducted throughout and 100% all LED lighting, so it's super efficient. Some of your main lighting control switches are right here. You've also got just regular on and off switches throughout the coach. Digital controls for the thermostat allows you to set up two separate zones. We did bring this one in wired for a second air conditioner. It doesn't currently have it, but it is a 50 amp service coach, so if you wanted to add that second air conditioner, then you can set up two separate zones for the bedroom and then the living area down below. You've also got a built-in Wi-Fi ranger, which is something that they've only started doing in the last year or so. It's also got the ability to become an LTE network if you work with your cell phone provider. And then down below that, of course, you got your fuse panel, and there's a LED light associated with each fuse, so if it happens to pop, it's gonna be a little red LED light showing through that little smoke screen. Let's head right into the bathroom here. And a pretty nice sized bathroom in this particular Rockwood. One thing I really like that they did this season is they extended the wardrobe slide out to give you a little bit of a linen closet here in the bathroom. And as you see, kind of Jack and Jill entry into the bedroom. I'll meet you in there in a minute. But I want to point out, nice glass enclosure on your shower. You actually have a medicine cabinet above the sink. It is a pretty good sized stone cast sink. As my camera guy rotates around to the bedroom, we'll show you. You got some storage down below. You got a really nice area for like your spitting cup and your toothbrushes, and then a nice medicine cabinet up above it. And again, everything's screwed together, not just stapled together the way Rockwood does it. And I want to point out one final thing before we leave the bathroom. It's the shower miser or the water saver system. So essentially, this is just going to be a diverter valve, really. It's going to put that water back through the hot water heater until that little blue pipe becomes translucent. Then you know your water's hot at the faucet. You flip a dial and it's going to come out right there. So it's going to stretch out your fresh as well as your gray tank. And now let's take a look at this really good sized wardrobe closet. This goes all the way across here. I like the fact they got individual hanger things, so when you take a turn or something, your clothes aren't sloshing back and forth. Pretty good bank of drawers on this side, the driver's side. Above that, you've also got a 12 volt USB outlet, as well as a car lighter style outlet, regular 110 outlet on each side of the bed, and some awesome overhead storage as well. And before I rotate to the other side and show you the little cabinet on the passenger side, I'd like to point out all the storage under the bed. And while we're here, this is something else I like to mention, because you get a lot of guys in the industry who will say, oh, I'm aluminum framed, and it's true in their sidewalls, usually wooden roof trusses, a lot of them have wooden rear walls. Everybody's gonna have one by one wood framing out their beds and their dinettes and stuff, except Rockwood, and they do that with double welting on every joint, full welds too, not just a tack weld on all their aluminum framing, and that's true in your roof trusses. The only wood you'll find in Rockwood is in the 5/8 tongue groove marine grade plywood in the decking, in the cabinets, and of course in the name. Taking a look at the outside here, the 2898KS, one thing I really love Rockwood's done this season, all your controls are now in a central location in here in the pass-through storage area, so you can pass through this little slot, lock it up, and secure it. They've made it real easy for you as well, showing you how to set these different toggles, whether you're going to be at a city connection, filling your tank, you're going to be dry camping, or if you're just sanitizing the unit. Here's where you would install that water filter that I mentioned inside for the water filtration system, and then the controls for the electric ground control 3.0 auto leveling that is on this particular unit. And this particular unit we bring in with a 6-gallon direct spark ignition hot water heater. So what that means to you is no pilot light to light. Whether you're on a run on gas or electric, you simply flip the switch inside, if I can get the words out of my mouth, and it's gonna recover at over 16 gallons an hour. Right here, we're below the hot water heater, you've got both your gray tank dump valves, as well as your black tank, and both of those, you'll notice, head right up to the fully enclosed underbelly. That does have direct heat pads on each water tank, and where those pipes come, your drain pipes come out of the enclosure, it's wrapped in that blow and expanding foam insulation. Something else I wanna point out, if you look here, Rockwood does make sure that your gate valves are up in there too. So where that water is actually going to pool is up in the enclosed heated part of the underbelly. As we rotate here, you'll see we have the two slide outs here on the driver's side. You got your kitchen slide out as well as one of the living room slide outs. Spot to fill your fresh water tank as well as to hook up your 50 amp power cord. You do have a nice storage rack on the back as well. This guy can flip up when you're not using it, then it flips down. It'll hold up to 200 pounds of cargo. Full walk on roof. So we do bring it in with the ladder so you can get up there, check your seals at the beginning and the end of the season. It's also pre-wired for the Furion observation camera. If that's something you decide to have installed, we could do that right here in our parts store. Now as we rotate over to the passenger side, or what I like to call the campsite side of the coach, I want to point out you do have the really nice frameless automotive style windows. That's nice for a couple reasons. A, it keeps your seals all in there so they're not exposed to the elements, but B, it actually opens up from the bottom. So if it's a light rainstorm outside, you can go ahead and leave those windows open and get that cross breeze. Right above that, you've got your two outdoor speakers. And then as we continue along here, you've got the spot for the barbecue grill. So it comes with a nice rack that'll hook on here, and the grill just slides on next to it with a little prep table right next to it. Above that, you do have hookups, so if you wanted to bring your TV outside, you've got cable as well as power out here. Now, I also want to point out, under that kind of bench area on the inside is a perfect spot to store that barbecue grill and the prep table. Down below, this is something that sets Rockwood way ahead of the curve. They use what's called a torsion flex axle, so it's like a torsion bar inside of the axle, giving you independent suspension on each wheel. And something that they finally started offering this season is the tire pressure monitoring system. Since we have our yellow valve stem cap, we know this has got the tire pressure monitoring system on it, which for you is really nice, especially in Colorado when you're going from 90, 95 down here and temperatures, you know, just above freezing in the mountains at night. All right, some of the final things I'll point out here on this Rockwood 2898KS, you've got a very nice extends 8-foot power awning, full strip of LED lights under the awning. You do have the ability to pitch it too, so if it's raining, you can kind of direct that water to go off one side. And then as you go to your entry door, you've got a really nice screen door here, as well as a really big assist grab handle to help you traverse in and out of the coach. But one of my favorite things that they've got is the solid steps here. So they're the nicer set of solid steps. Actually have a built-in piston, gas piston, so you can bring them up, sweep them off before you fold them up inside the coach and get ready to head home from your campsite. All right, guys, thanks for taking the time to spend with me here at the Great Outdoors RV Company, checking out one of the newest Rockwood Ultralight fifth wheels, the 2898KS. There's a lot more to go over than I did in this short, brief video. So if you have any questions, feel free to send me an email, ryan@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Give us a call, 970-313-4337. And make sure you subscribe and like our page so that every time we have new content that we put up, you will be notified of it. And if you have any questions, feel free to share them in the comments section. Thanks, guys. We'll be right back.